Guys, ChatGPT's weekly users have exploded to 700 million active weekly users. They just released this number, but that's not the crazy part. What's crazy is the growth. They have 4x'd since this point last year, and they've seen a 40% increase since March. They've seen a 40% increase from 500 million to 700 million in just a few months. That is absolutely insane. So I said to myself, well, what's causing this growth? Where's this growth coming from? Well, in March, they released their new model GPT-4, which attracted 130 million new users. But why did they join? Well, there were a lot of new features, but one of the features that really brought a lot of new people on board was image generation. And up until that point, you weren't really using ChatGPT for image generation, but at that time, there were just mass virality. I actually posted a video about how to create studio Ghibli images in ChatGPT because they went mega viral. So people were making Studio Ghibli images. They were turning themselves into Simpsons characters, Family Guy characters, all sorts of image generation. And now, honestly, the ChatGPT image generator is, in my opinion, quite excellent. You can do some really, really cool, fun things with the ChatGPT image generation, and they saw a huge increase in users. But to me, this is not the end. ChatGPT, guys, is just getting warmed up. They are just getting warmed up. And by the way, if you want to stay updated on everything that's happening in the world, I'm posting daily videos to YouTube right here. Make sure you like and subscribe the videos so you stay alerted. But there's just stuff coming out all the time. The only day I don't release is on Sunday, because on Sundays we rest, boys. Sundays we rest. So anyway, subscribe so you stay updated on the newest news, because this is crazy what AI is doing in the world. AI changes everything. And what I'm excited about is GPT-5. ChatGPT-5 is scheduled to release early August. It could be any day. And the press release could happen any moment. I mean, it could be happening right now. For all I know, I've got my finger on the pulse. But ChatGPT-5 is coming very soon. And what is going to happen with ChatGPT-5? We could see another big increase in the user base. I mean, the merging, what are they planning on doing? They're going to be merging certain versions together. So, for example, right now, you would use model 4.0 for kind of like everyday purposes. You might use 0.3 for different purposes. So you're using these different models of ChatGPT for different uses. Well, they're planning on merging them all together under ChatGPT-5, just to make it a little bit more user-friendly. They have the deep research model, which obviously you're gonna be using for research and reading, looking for reports and data and statistics and stuff like that. In any event, they're gonna be merging those together, which I think will make for a much easier, simpler experience. They plan on enhancing the agent multi-models and give it better reasoning. So overall, just a lot of enhancements there. We'll see about like what happens with the virality. One of the things I think that's interesting about images and video is you can see the difference. It's harder to see the difference when you're just communicating back and forth. But in any event, ChatGPT-5 is coming any day now. But what's also interesting to me, again, is why are people spending so much time using ChatGPT? Getting people to log in on a weekly basis, getting 700 million people to log in on a weekly basis, in some cases, multiple times a day. People are spending more time. I think the average is about 16 minutes per day people are spending on ChatGPT. Unbelievable numbers. And by the way, just a quick side note, out of that 700 million, a lot of those users are not just everyday soccer moms. These are businesses, these are enterprises. We're talking about the money here in just a moment, and if you stick around, I'll even give you some ways that you can leverage this huge boom to make money on your own. These are different things that I've used to make money, or some things I'm looking at. So anyway, if you want to stick around, I'll give you some ideas on how you can hop on this wave, on this tsunami, if it were, to make more money for yourself. But at any rate, why are people spending so much time? Well, people are getting an emotional connection to ChatGPT. For better or worse, there's an emotional connection. Like, for example, if you log into ChatGPT and you hit the button to have a conversation with it, it's gonna know your name. So it's gonna pop open and say, "Hey Jim, how can I help you?" And it sounds like a human. People are starting the voice connection is real. I'm gonna post another link to a video here where I covered what's happening with AI companions. Because guys, this is insane. People are falling in love with their AI chats, their AI chat bots. It is nutso. I'm not gonna go into all the details. This link here to the video will show you what's happening with AI chat bots, but It is crazy what's happening. And this is not just my speculation. You look at the numbers, people are using AI more often for longer periods of time for all sorts of different types of problems, and they're ending up creating an emotional connection, these AI bots. And by the way, side note, big tech companies know this is happening and they freaking love it. They are leaning in. You know, on X a couple weeks ago, and this is what prompted me to record that video about the AI companions, Elon was pushing this AI chatbot, Annie, which was very flirtatious and almost sexual. Well, not almost, it was sexual. And what these big tech companies understand is that if they can get you emotionally connected to their AI chatbot, you're gonna keep coming back for more. You'll end up developing a strong relationship and bond with their AI than with other human beings. And I don't wanna go down a huge rabbit hole there, but you can kind of see where that can lead. But how are these numbers actually impacting the revenue? I mean, it's absolutely nuts. The paying business users jumped from 3 million paying users in June to 5 million paying users in August. That's so crazy to me that you almost doubled your paying user base in 2 months. That's so nuts. And for all you people out there that say AI isn't a big deal and it's all a hype bubble, these are actual real people that are paying for these tools. Now, granted, there's some of these are going to be enterprise and business users who are paying, and they might find that, well, I didn't really get the return I was expecting, so maybe I'll hire back all my customer service reps. That's something that Klarna did recently. But it does, at least to me, show a real number that a lot of people are liking it. They like the free trial, they're paying for more, they're telling their friends. And again, I've been a paying ChatGPT user for a while. I'm not going away. I've integrated it into a lot of different automations, and I just think it's really cool. Another, just a quick side note here, you know, I'm on YouTube every day posting, and I'm trying to find like what works, what are people interested in. There are 1.7 million searchers for ChatGPT monthly. And that doesn't even include all the different versions like ChatGPT 4.0 or how to make money with ChatGPT or ChatGPT 3.0 mini or ChatGPT 5 or GPT or custom GPTs. Like, there's a lot of different ways that people search for that. But just the word ChatGPT by itself, 1.7 million searches. So there's a lot of people leveraging and using ChatGPT. I mean, the growth there is absolutely bananas. And so what that has gotten me thinking about is, well, how do I leverage my experience to help people use it? How can I actually make money with ChatGPT? What are some opportunities? And so I want to kind of share some of these ideas with you now, some of the ways that I'm using ChatGPT, some best practices, and some things that you might think about to make some more money on your own. Because let's face it, I mean, I talk about this all the time, guys. This is a sink or swim moment for a lot of people. Or let me put it this way. It's a sink, swim, or surf moment for a lot of people. And if you can start to learn how these tools operate, if you can speak the language, if you can use them, you can absolutely skyrocket your efficiency. Okay, guys? And you're going to find ways to make money that maybe weren't there in the past. And if you decide, no, I'm going to keep doing things the way that I always did them, you might find yourself irrelevant. And of course, there was a internet bubble that burst, but we're on the internet all day, every day now. So it's not like the internet is gone. There was a lot of hype, sure, and a lot of companies went bust. It's going to be the same thing with AI, but AI could be even 10x bigger than the internet was in the way that we interact with it. And that's what we're covering in this channel. And by the way, guys, there's so much news coming in. I can't cover it all on my daily walk and talk, but you can get the biggest news on my newsletter, AIUpdate.ai, sending that out 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday. On Sunday, we rest. But you can get that newsletter. Just go to AIUpdate.ai. And I'm just kind of sharing the biggest news of the day, which, believe it or not, there's a lot of it. There's a lot of it. Funny story. I was actually talking to my wife the other night. I'm like, gosh, I got a problem. She said, Mark, what's up? What's your problem? And I said, well, there's so much interesting news. I don't know what to talk about on YouTube tomorrow. She's like, oh, that's a good problem to have. I'm like, yeah, it is a good problem to have. But anyway, so I decided I'm going to put more effort into the newsletter because there's so many interesting stories happening. Okay, so let's talk about ChatGPT. How can we make money? So I think there's a couple things to keep in mind right off the cusp. By the way, there's a friendly rabbit here kind of hanging out with me. We have a lot of rabbits here in Florida. I love where I live, Florida rocks. But how do we make money, or how do we make sure that ChatGPT is actually working for us? There's a couple things to understand with ChatGPT, one of which is memory. ChatGPT has four places where it can store memory. I'm gonna put a link, I've recorded an entire video on how to optimize your memory. I'll put a link to it here. But one of the things that makes ChatGPT interesting is there's four different places where it can remember conversations that you've had. That's how it remembers your name. It remembers what you're into, what your business is. Kind of a cool thing that you can do actually is ask ChatGPT to give you an assessment on yourself. What do you think about me? Where are my gaps? What are my opportunities? Where am I making mistakes? It's kind of an interesting thing that you can do with ChatGPT because it has a memory. So there's places you can tweak and turn off memory. You can optimize memory in different ways. So make sure that you're optimizing your memory usage in order to get the best result, A. B, standard operating procedures. If you're a business owner, if you're using ChatGPT for certain reasons, you need to have documents, PDFs, instructions on standard operating procedures, key talking points. You need to be able to program and optimize your ChatGPT so that when you ask it a question like, how do I make more money in my business? It already knows everything about your business. You understand what I'm saying? It knows who your avatars are. It knows what your customer service looks like. It knows what your frequently asked questions are like. It understands your vision, your mission. It understands your upsell opportunities. It gets all of that. It understands your websites, your landing pages. You need to have a master SOP that you are updating on a regular basis, and you're making sure that you're programming that into ChatGPT so that it understands how to help you. It gives the context that it needs. And you want to have that systematized and put together in a way so you can constantly optimize. Okay, and then another thing that is important, this is kind of like the number, there's a lot of ways you can optimize ChatGPT, but I'm kind of hitting the big ones. The other one is to make sure that you have accurate first party and third party data. So you're going to want to make sure that ChatGPT has relevant financials, charts, market movements. Again, this is probably something you'll want to update on a quarterly basis. So you want to make sure that it has the proper numbers so they can properly advise you. Now, keep in mind, there are privacy concerns there. So you're not going to be uploading like social security numbers, sensitive personal information. Be careful with that because there have been leaks. Even just this past week, there was a leak where people on Google were able to get access to personal chats from ChatGPT. So you got to be careful the information that you're putting into ChatGPT. That said, if you're able to give ChatGPT better information, you're going to get better results back. So how do we make money out of it? Well, I'm going to give you a few ways that I personally use it on a daily basis. And in some of these ways, it makes me money. In some ways, it saves me money. So I'm just going to list them off real quick. I'm not going to go into a bunch of context on it. But I use it for reading charts, graphs, spreadsheets, you know, interpreting data, like I mentioned before. That's important. Generating lists. I can generate all sorts of lists for all sorts of reasons. Personally, generate a list of exercises I can do today. What are the types of foods that I should be eating? What are some things I could do with my kids based on the area that I'm in? Professionally, what is give me a task list for the day. What are some things that I need to get done that I've been putting off? I want to accomplish X. What are the steps to complete it? Again, list building. And by the way, if you're not sure what to do with ChatGPT, ask ChatGPT to generate you a list of different ways that it can help you grow your business. Okay, finding news stories. I use ChatGPT to find news stories. By the way, quick side note, it is becoming increasingly difficult to find accurate information online. One of the things that I found is that there are a lot of so ChatGPT will reference websites that have used ChatGPT to generate blogs for that website, but it is very difficult to corroborate the data and the numbers there. So I typically don't use those as good references. So this is becoming, I think, a potential need, is having trusted websites that are giving you accurate information. Because the problem is that with AI and AI agents, they can just create blogs at scale. I know guys that are creating hundreds, if not thousands, of blogs every day for websites, which is great for SEO. But the problem is that it leads to misinformation and bad data. So kind of like I mentioned before, you want to be training your AI bots with clean, accurate first party and third party data. Anyway, I digress. Reviewing applications is something that I've done. You know, if I'm, having someone apply for a particular position or job or task, etc., I have them answer some questions. I send that through ChatGPT automatically using an API integration, and then ChatGPT will let me know if they're a good fit or not. And that's a way that I can kind of use AI as an SDR to make sure that they're a good qualified employee, lead, etc. Using it to writing blogs, email newsletters. I use it to discuss ideas. I just put it in my chat and I have conversations back and forth. So those are a bunch of ways that I'm using AI. Now, I also want to talk about some ways that I'm either considering using ChatGPT to make money with, or some ways that you can kind of think. And by the way, just a quick side note, thanks for subscribing to the channel so you can stay up to date and actually crush it with AI. But the better you are at using AI, the better the ideas you're going to get with AI, the better you're going to be able to find new ways to make money, okay? And it, as I mentioned before, if you follow the steps before and making sure that ChatGPT is properly programmed and knows a lot about you and your business, the better the ideas you're going to get back, okay? Ways to make money with ChatGPT, let's get into it. Freelance copywriting. Find gigs, write blogs, you can write them very, very quickly with ChatGPT. Designing logos, social media graphics, you can automate this, a lot of it, but you can create tons and tons of compelling images, and they're very good, better than what most graphic designers can do by a lot. Use ChatGPT to create low-hanging fruit to sell. So if you're into digital products, you can create guides, SOPs, resources lists, templates. ChatGPT can write these out really quick, you can double-check them for accuracy, and you can implement them into a sales funnel. Okay, pretty simple. This is something that I'm working on right now. I'll probably be trying to sell it to you in the future, but it's not ready yet. When it's ready, I'll let you know. And you're not gonna be, by the way, as a YouTube viewer, you're not gonna be my primary audience for this. I'm gonna be selling it to cold leads through meta ads. And I'm gonna be using AI to create different types of ads and in ad copy. I'll be using Google Gemini to create different types of video. Anyway, long story short, cold traffic into digital products. Create GPTs that are optimized. You can create and sell GPTs. Those are custom GPTs built within ChatGPT. Implement them into your sales and marketing funnel. Custom info product, responses to answers, responses to user answers. So this is something that I'm very interested in and will likely be rolling out into sales funnels in the near future. And basically the way this works is you have a problem that someone has. Let's say how to find a job in 2025, okay? And you say, well, fill out this questionnaire, which will have like where you live, what your salary is, what you expect to make, what your skill set is, what you're interested in, and then it will use AI to give you a custom response. And sure, you could do this pretty easily on your side, but again, if you have good inputs, if you're able to train the AI with a better prompt, with better data, you can give a better response and it can be all customized. So I think this is a really cool kind of space for digital products. You create an AI automation agency. There's plenty of information out there, but basically what that does is I'm going to combine this with the next one. Solve problems within your own organization using AI. And they kind of work the same way, I think. As you're able to solve your own problems with AI, other people will likely have those same problems. So if you're able to solve it for yourself, you can go to someone else and say, hey, I can solve that problem for you. It's $1,000, it's $5,000, it's $10,000, depends on the problem. And then you might be able to even automate that to create some monthly recurring revenue, and you can kind of scale it out from there. So this type of AI automation agency model, I think, is solid too. So guys, infinite ways to use ChatGPT to make money. I'm just blown away by how many people are on ChatGPT right now. It is crazy. It is blowing up, and it's to me, it's scary on one side, but this is an extremely exciting time on the other hand. Yesterday, I talked about this, and before I close it out here again, thanks for subbing, but yesterday I was talking about this and how AI is revolutionizing financial services. Guys, 65% of Gen Z and millennials are comfortable using ChatGPT and AI tools for financial advice. That's insane. If you're a financial advisor, you could be dead in the water. But what was interesting doing my research is predictions, and again, these are just predictions. There's not hard facts and data. Predictions show that actually this will create more opportunities. What do those opportunities look like? Check out yesterday's video. I think you'll be very fascinated with what's happening in the finance world when it comes to AI. I'll see you there, boys. Peace.